Hi folks, Artist Mac here, and as a regular user of the Southside Red Line CTA that they just closed down last Sunday for 5 months, I am not happy. I'm really not happy with the fact that the CTA is trying to pee on my leg and tell me it's raining, saying, oh well, we had to close it down because the tracks were deteriorated because they were 45 years old. The tracks did not deteriorate because they were 45 years old. They deteriorated because the CTA wasn't taking care of them. The State Street subway is older than the Southside Red Line. It'll be 70 years old this year. The Howard Red Line, those tracks are even older than the State Street subway. The part from Wilson up to Howard dates from 1907. The part from the loop all the way out to Wilson, most of which is used by the Red Line now, some by the Ravenswood, that part dates from 1900. And those tracks aren't deteriorated like they let the Red Line get to on the south side. Of course, the Howard Red Line serves the north side where the decision makers live. The Blue Line, going out to Forest Park, is 11 years older than the Southside Red Line. It opened in 1958. But that's a different story. The Forest Park Blue Line serves UIC and the Med Center and Oak Park and suburbs west of there. So, of course, they're not going to let that go down. And when the tracks had deteriorated on the O'Hare Blue Line, the CTA didn't shut it down completely. You know, they shut parts of it down on the weekends. They ran shuttle buses between various stations. But they never shut it all the way down. And the part of the Blue Line between Jefferson Park and O'Hare is 15 years newer than the Dan Ryan Red Line. The part between Logan Square and Jefferson Park is the same age. And they didn't shut down the Brown Line completely when they were doing all that construction work on it a couple of years ago. I mean, if the stores along the Brown Line up there were complaining about lost business, boy, what do you think would have happened to them if they had shut the Brown Line down completely for 6 months? But what really frosts me is 55th, 63rd, 69th, 79th, 87th, and 95th all get bus shuttles. Of course, they were going to take care of Chinatown. They've got the R22 overnight shuttle bus. Goes all the way to the Roosevelt station. Yeah, they're going to take care of Chinatown and the tourists. 35th doesn't need one. The 35th Street Green Line station is a block from the one that they closed. So the White Sox fans and all these little IIT students, they're taken care of. 47th Street, we got nothing. No shuttles, just the same crappy hit-or-miss 47th Street bus service we had before, where you wait for 20 minutes for a bus and then two of them show up, or three. And right now, and I hope after the CTA sees this, that situation will change, riders who used to use that 47th Street Red Line station between 1 and 4 in the morning, right now, they have no options. The number 29 State bus, the number 24 Wentworth bus, and the number 47 have all stopped running by that time. And what does the CTA expect you to do if you get off that 47th Street Green Line, Red Line, whatever they're calling it, at 2 a.m.? And the buses have stopped running? Let's take a look at the Red Line South Reroute Planner online. Let's say you lived near that closed 47th Street Red Line station. You work downtown or on the near north side or the north side along the Red Line at a bar or a restaurant or someplace else with a 2 a.m. closing time, and you need to get to work and back home. Now, going to work might not be a problem, but let's see what happens if you had to come home at 2 a.m. So we're just gonna put in a downtown address. For an example, 70 West Monroe. And then we'll put in an address, 315 West 47th, not mine, but it's a block away from that closed 47th Street Red Line station. Day we'd like to be traveling, the weekday, leave at 2 a.m. Take me there. And this takes you to Google Maps. Yep, this is what the CTA expects people to do who used to take the 47th Street Red Line downtown and now have to take this new red line that goes along the Green Line tracks. It's all good until you get down to the 47th Street Red Green Line station, whatever they want to call it. It's between Prairie and Calumet on 47th. See that black line? That horizontal black line going to point B, where you want to be? The CTA expects you to walk. And here it is in writing on the left side of that map. Yeah, you're good walking from 70 West Monroe to the Red Line subway. That's still the way it always was. Then you go farther down. You get to the 47th Street Green Line station, and they actually expect you to walk. 16 minutes on that stretch of 47th Street at 2 o'clock in the morning. What would it be like to walk that stretch of 47th Street at 2 o'clock in the morning? Let's take a field trip. And if you think I'm walking that stretch of 47th Street at 2 o'clock in the morning, you've been smoking that high-grade medicinal marijuana. We're driving. We're coming up on this new Red Green Line station. It's open 24 hours now. You know, it runs 24/7. The only problem is, the buses don't run 24/7. Right, here's a train pulling into the station now. Now this is the route that the CTA expects people to walk to get to the closed 47th Street Red Line station. And that intersection that we passed back there, 47th and Prairie, that's where a Columbia College student got shot to death at 11 o'clock at night. He was walking up to the station to walk a friend back to his house because he knew how dangerous that station was. And it may look kind of empty now out here on these streets, but I guarantee you, I guarantee you, when warm weather comes, because it's about 55 out here now, when warm weather comes, these streets will be crawling with lowlifes. Now, this is only about a 5-minute trip by car. 15 minutes walking at 1 o'clock in the morning. Let's see, no, it's about 1:10 now. No. Now there is a 47th Street bus off to the left there, and that's going to be probably the last one until 4:35 in the morning. There's the closed res line. And for some reason, even though it's closed, they still keep the lights on. And the CTA shouldn't wait for something to happen. It's already happened. Like I said during that driving video, at 47th and Prairie, a block west of that station, a young man, a Columbia College student, was shot to death. And he wasn't making that 15-minute walk. He lived in the neighborhood. He was just walking up to that station to meet a friend of his who was coming to visit him so he wouldn't have to walk back to the kid's house alone. He knew how dangerous that neighborhood was. And as it turned out, it was more dangerous for him than he ever dreamed. What the CTA needs to do is to either extend some kind of shuttle from the 55th Street station, where all the shuttles are going, somehow extend a shuttle to 47th Street so that we're covered. Either that, or make the number 29 State or the number 24 Wentworth buses 24/7 operations until this whole mess is completed. And of course the media found people who work 9 to 5 and are safely in their beds by the time the buses stop running, saying,
"Oh, I thought it was really going to be bad, but it was actually faster."
Oh, and in case you think I'm a little hostile toward the CTA, here's another little factoid to throw out at your next cocktail party. In 1978, when the Dan Ryan L wasn't even 10 years old, the CTA found cracks in that elevated structure that they built in 1969 to connect the Dan Ryan L over to the South Side L tracks back when it was hooked up to the Lake Street line. In fact, it's hooked up to the same tracks that the Green Line use now. Did the CTA repair those cracks? No. They basically hung Christmas tree lights on them. For what reason, I don't know. I guess so drivers passing underneath would know where they were. They did not repair those cracks until the Orange Line, which uses that structure now, was built 15 years later. I don't want to read anything into that decision. You figure it out.